Greetings, subscribing tons. Today I want to talk a bit about the decline and fall of the Roman Empire. No, okay, not really. The decline and fall of Twitter. But before I begin to do so, I would like to share some absolutely glorious news. We have a new pair of MMA shorts over at LegioGloria.com. Absolutely satisfied with them. The cut, the material, the design, the feel, everything. Swedish company, made in Poland, Hungarian designer, and of Greek myth. So team Mother Europe all the way. Very happy with them, as I said. Check it out, first link in the description box below. Now on to the topic at hand, about Twitter. Well, first and foremost, talk about my own relationship with Twitter. I will talk about my feelings. It's okay for men to talk about their feelings. So if we're talking about Facebook in its heyday, yeah, that was a platform I really liked, really enjoyed it, got something, you know, good value out of it. Up until I got banned on Instagram, I really liked the platform as well. Good stuff. YouTube, of course, I can honestly say that, yeah, I loved YouTube, at least back in the day. It's a bit different now, though, when I'm shadow banned, and if I'm lucky, I can reach out to my own subscribers. That's also why I make exclusive content on Odyssey, because I can still see it growing there, even if I can't grow on YouTube. And that's also why I've had a bit more motivation and joy in making videos as of late, because I can grow that platform. Now, Twitter itself, I have 20 or 21,000 subscribers. I don't know how many users they have purged, but it's a platform where I have, you know, effortlessly grown. I haven't put in any effort at all, especially compared to YouTube or Instagram, where I've actually put in a lot of work over all these years. Twitter, however, it's a platform you don't really need to put in a lot of work, a lot of thought, a lot of effort. If I were to get banned tomorrow on Twitter, I wouldn't be particularly sad. Most guys and girls who have a bit more initiative, they've already followed me on other platforms, and my primary reason for being on Twitter now is to actually promote people to go to, you know, Gab, Telegram, Odyssey, etc. So that is my view on Twitter right now. And of course, the video isn't about my own feelings if I think Twitter is fun or not. Twitter is fun and you can gain a lot of insights on it. So I'm not bashing the platform as it was, but it has become quite boring as of late. This is not only, again, because of my own personal feelings, it's because they have banned and censored so many individuals. So it doesn't really feel fun anymore. And a platform, it needs to be fun for people to want to be there. So you can compare with Gab, which is a free speech platform, which I'm more active on now. I encourage you to follow me. Link is in the description box as well. And when I say free speech, I'm not interested. I'm not out for, you know, seeing guys post edgy, radical, racial slurs. It's not what I'm about. It's not what I'm interested in. I'm interested in reading good, interesting takes, a nice analysis of a recent event, some information. But Twitter, they ban and censor people who share, you know, interesting takes, etc. That is the issue. So it's not about I want to have a platform where everyone is rude. If you are on Gab, I would please, for my sake, be polite and don't write any stupid things, because Gab will only get into trouble for it. But you can definitely share forbidden wisdom in a polite and professional manner, so to speak. So that's basically the difference now between Twitter and Gab. If you can't have any creative freedom, or if you can't share your thoughts, if you can't have a good, mature discussion on politics or whatever, social issues, because you will get banned, yeah, of course, it's not particularly fun. And now someone might say, oh, but you know, there are many more people on Twitter as opposed to Gab, etc. But I'm not necessarily out, and I suggest that you shouldn't be out to just be where the most people are at. If we are on the path to enlightenment, And here's something you need to keep in mind, that guys and girls like us, who are interested in certain topics, we are a tiny minority. The majority of people, they are still more interested in hearing about gossip and drama. And if you look at the biggest YouTube channels, for example, yeah, it's not about necessarily something deeper, except for PewDiePie, of course, who actually does great videos every once in a while. You know, he has a very sharp mind. You can definitely tell it when he talks about books, etc. But otherwise, except for PewDiePie, it's all pleb-tier entertainment. That's not what we're about. So instead of viewing it, oh, there are so few people on this platform, it's not necessarily about where the most people are at, because most people are NPCs anyway, so it doesn't really matter. And for me, as I said before, I want to reach the high initiative people who can actually do something productive. So instead of me spending time talking about something and I know it's just gonna fall on deaf ears, yeah, it's better to maybe have a smaller audience, but you can actually do something proactive with them. And I am actually a bit nostalgic even for the days before social media really took off, and you had more web pages and blogs, etc., where people could write about their thoughts, etc. So instead of being so focused on, oh, I want to be where the most people are, focus more on where can I find the most interesting takes, where can I read the most interesting stuff, where can I reach forbidden enlightenment, so to speak. Yeah, probably not on Twitter, because if someone is popular and interesting enough, they'll probably get banned, whereas on Gab maybe you can they can speak freely. So anyway, the decline and fall of Twitter. Simple analysis, it's simply not fun anymore, because a lot of people have gotten banned for citing crime statistics or whatever it might be. And you know, when the censorship, it goes so far, even if I am on Twitter still, I don't really feel all too comfortable producing content for a platform which might ban me any day. I'm more comfortable then to be on a platform, promote a platform where I can actually be in peace and post physique. So Physique Friday tomorrow on Gab, just tag with Physique Friday, you can tag me as well. Always fun, nice to see, good training motivation. So that's a weekly tradition, and I highly encourage you to sign up. Then of course, if you aren't on any social media, that's fine, as long as you follow me on my Telegram channel and watch my videos, I'm happy. But yeah, I think the time to abandon Twitter has come. That being said, of course, I will continue to be there. Primary reason so I can continue to push other platforms, and I will be more active on Telegram, of course, is my main platform. Then Gab as well, where I can interact. So if you want interaction on the Telegram channel, that interaction is on Gab instead. So anyway, check out all links in the description box below. Thank you for watching. XOXO. Boom.